right now, you're asleep, enjoying your last peaceful night's rest for God knows how long. And I thought I'd record something for you to remember me by while you're locked away inside Charleston Fire Department. Training for the prestigious opportunity to dive face first into a bunch of mine fires with the rest of those firebreaker nut jobs. Honestly, though, ain't no responder alive who's a better pick for that crew than you. Just make sure you don't forget the basics with all this fancy new training. Always check your seals, hit stop, drop, then roll. The order's important. And most important, don't come back all crispy. Because I love what I'm looking at right now.
Hi, this is Gabe Ramses, and I'm leaving this message to inform the Parks and Rec Department of the horrible experience my family and I had this week at the Alpine River Cabins. Look, we were all looking forward to a nice weekend getaway in the wilderness, but between the constant shooting in the cabins, rodent swarms, and blood-curdling screams, well, I'm more stressed than I was before. My boys were so upset they swore they saw the picture frame spinning on the walls. My tax dollars pay your salaries, so I demand recompense, or you can bet I'll do my darndest to make sure that money is in someone else's pocket next election. And one more thing. Maybe you could get off your lazy butts and pick up some garbage here. This place is filthy. I know all the recent hubbub about atomic war, but that doesn't mean the place has to look like it was just hit with a nuclear bomb!
Thank you. ready to have their ass kicked!
Don't face the wasteland without the proper supplies. Welcome, citizen. I am authorized to trade supplies. Requisitions now available. Isn't Grafton beautiful? Our little trading boat is so lucky to be here.
time to open your mind to the strange, bizarre, and sometimes terrifying world that exists in the shadows and fringes of our own, where myth, legend, and rumor are made real. Yes, it's time for more thrilling Tales from the West Virginia Hills. Tonight's episode of Beast of Grafton is brought to you by Dandy Boy Apples. Apples so good, they never go bad. And remember, an apple a day keeps the doctor away. That's Dandy Boy Apples. Fresh, delicious, and dandy every time. Pick up a box today. Our tale begins in the rural hills near Grafton, where locals have reported a strange creature lurking in the woods. Robbie Cockrell and Peggy Mansfield were out on a date, celebrating Peggy's birthday. A full moon loomed large as they drove.
Robbie, you're going too fast.
Don't worry, this nuclear road's ahead of like a dream.
Where are you taking me anyway?
I told you, it's a birthday surprise.
Way out here in the woods? There's nothing this far out of Grafton, except that hospital by the river. Wait, I bet we're going to that new drive-in over in Clarksburg, right? Just so you can show off your slick new hot rod.
Ah, come on. Don't be like that, Peggy. I just thought the drive-in would be romantic.
Oh, Robbie. Robbie, look out!
You weren't expecting a computer to be Grafton's mayor. Well, let me tell you, I used to be the mayor's assistant, but when he stopped showing up for work, I ran for office. I am eminently qualified, and the town unanimously elected me 1-0. Unfortunately, you are a wee bit early for tourist season. But this is your lucky day. Help us get ready for the upcoming flood of eager tourists, and I'll knock a whole 5% off the cost of all attractions. We have 4 major attractions around here. Wavy Willard's, the Clarksburg Shooting Range, Cricket's Fort, and a Black Bear Hunting Lodge. Go out there and get each of them ready. I'll wait here, because I don't have legs, and I can't move.
Tonight, we bring you the final chapter of The Beast of Grafton. When last we left off, 2 teenagers, Robbie Cockrell and Peggy Mansfield, were running for their lives after a harrowing car accident, trying to escape a frightening creature stalking them.
See? You're doing great. Just like when we won that 3-legged race in the park. We're almost to the hospital.
Oh no. There it is! I see it! Coming out of the woods!
It's bigger than a bear!
Look, it has no head! It's just flesh and muscle and claws!
Nate's in it. My girlfriend's in it.
There's something after us. A monster. It's a what?
Oh, a monster.
I know. It sounds crazy, but I can't with my car and...
I see. It's just you two?
Yes, it's just us. Oh, won't you help us, Doctor, please?
Of course we'll take care of you, my dear. Do come in. Come in.
See? I told you everything was going to be okay, Peggy. Doctor, are you going to call the police about the thing outside?
Well, all in good time, son. First, let's have a look at the girl's foot. Lie down on this table, dear.
Is it bad, Doctor?
Nothing.